As indie filmmakers, we're always looking for equipment that has a good level of price to quality ratio. For a few years now, anytime we've needed shoulder rig parts like reels, handles, or little mounts so you can add more accessories to your rig, we've been using a company called SmallRig. They've found the sweet spot between quality and price. In this video, we're going to talk about some of their products and show how versatile they are. Welcome to the Film Look. Thanks to Rocketstock for providing the graphics we used in this episode. Their aspect pack includes 200 minimalist graphic elements designed to add a professional look to your project. Check them out for yourself by visiting rocketstock.com or via the link in the description below. SmallRig did send us over half the equipment we'll be talking about in this video, but the other half we've purchased over the last few years. Let's start off with a bare bones setup. For most small cameras, you can get cages, and from SmallRig, we have the Sony A7S Mark I cage. We have reviewed other cages for the Sony A7S, and you can find that video right here. The cage is one unit, and you don't have to disassemble a cage to take the camera out of it. You simply just place the camera in and screw it in from the bottom. Compared to other cages we have used for the Sony A7S, this one has a lot more room around the buttons and nothing is hidden behind any parts of the cage, so you can easily get access to them. It has three cold shoe connections so you can mount loads of accessories and an HDMI clamp which is adjustable to fit different size HDMI cables depending on which size you have. You can also get top handles for the cage. The one we have has loads of screw mounts so you can add more accessories, but SmallRig have other top handles to choose which also work with this cage. The cage also has a rosette connection which is built into the side. You can get many rosette accessories, but the one we like the most is the wooden handle, and it's not just because it looks cool. When going handheld, the grip is really comfortable and it gets your hands away from the lens, which prevents micro jitters. If you're not a fan of the wooden handle, you can also get the rubber handle like this one. By having a rosette connection on the side instead of a standard screw, it allows you to put more pressure and tension onto the handle and it won't slip because of the small grooves of the rosette. You can also get a bunch of other cages for other cameras from SmallRig, so go to the website and check them out. We're going to go into more detail about some of the pieces of camera equipment we use to build our filmmaking shoulder rig, so if you haven't already, consider subscribing. But in this video, we're going to talk about the rest of the SmallRig products we used to build the rig. To be able to add more equipment to your camera, we added a reel mount system to the bottom. You can get a Manfrotto SmallRig base plate to make this a little easier, but we already had this 15mm rod riser clamp. This is the setup. We have a Manfrotto plate screwed to the riser clamp, which is screwed into the bottom of the Manfrotto release plate, then the camera slides onto the release plate. Then you can add 15mm rods to the riser, add a follow focus, a battery, or even a monitor by using this little clamp. By setting up the camera this way, you can take the camera off the tripod with the reel mount attached, or you can release it from the tripod plate and leave the reel system behind. This setup works well on a tripod, but where the SmallRig components really come in handy is when you're building a shoulder rig. If you're trying to work out which components you need for your rig, go to the SmallRig website, look up what they have, and draw a couple of diagrams with all of the components you're thinking about buying. By doing this, you can see what components connect to each other and work out what you need to build your rig. The next setup we have is the shoulder rig setup. We swap out the 15mm rods for longer ones so we can attach a shoulder part and a cross front handle kit which has two rubber handles. We have the camera as far back as possible so the weight is more on my shoulder and not front heavy. We can still see what we're shooting by using the same rod clamp as before to mount the monitor as far forward on an articulating arm, so we can adjust the angle of the monitor with ease. The wooden handle is not really needed on the cage, so instead of using the cross front handle kit, you can get this rosette rod clamp so you can attach the wooden handle to the 15mm rods. By using only a few parts, we've managed to build many different setups which work in many different situations. You can get this rosette extension arm so the rig handles are not straight in front of you but down by your side, which is a lot more comfortable and means you can tuck your elbows in, creating a steadier shot. The cross front handle kit can be set up as a fig rig by turning the handles upside down and mounting them next to the camera. All of the components from SmallRig are built out of metal. The knobs tighten well and they're built with a ratchet system. So if you cannot turn the knob any further because there's something in the way, you just need to pull it out, turn it and tighten it. Like I said at the start of this video, SmallRig have a great price to quality ratio and they have lots of products to solve problems that you didn't even know you had. You can find links to all of the SmallRig products we mentioned in this video below if you want to start building your rig. If you want to support this channel, give us a thumbs up or down if you don't, hit the orange lens cap to subscribe, and remember, achieve it one shot at a time.